Nice.
I just
f***ed
the dude up.
I just f***ed the dude. Ah! So Halo armor is really freaking cool, but how close can we get to it in Destiny 2? So today we're going to be exploring that very thing. I told my Discord server to make some Halo-inspired fashion, and here's what they came up with. So for the first one on our list, we have Genesis, and he did one inspired by the Covenant Hunters. Now, I completely understand that most of these are going to be like you versus the person she tells you not to worry about. But like I said, these are going to be Halo inspired. I know that they are not going to be exactly the same because it is impossible to make it exactly the same. Now, all of that being said, I think Genesis did a wonderful job. Like instead of that giant like shield thing that they used to beat you down with, they have that like giant blade on the phenotype stuff. And the blue coloring is still pretty much the same here. And instead of having that like weird skin stuff that the hunters have, you still have that coloring present here in this Titan. Another thing that I was impressed by is that they also took care to have that same like general armor shape. You can really see it here in the helmet, how it still comes down to a point. I also want to point out that he's using a different armor piece in every single slot, so that is just the icing on the cake, and that's what makes me like this even more. Just like you should hit that like button before you end up like this dude here in the video. Okay, so this next one is going to be a warlock, and this one is from Just the Mouse, and they did a Promethean Knight. Okay, so for this one, I don't think it's that far of a stretch actually. I think Just the Mouse did a wonderful job here because you can already see that like orangish yellow glow going on there, and I thought it was absolutely genius on the fact that they used the lichen cover for the head. That way you can still get that like vampiric creature like vibe going on. Not to mention the fact that the whole entire set has all of these lines going through it, which match like the seams on the Promethean Knight's armor. You also have something that could resemble the like gun swords that they have on. They're on the phenotype plasticity gloves. And lastly, I do want to point out the collar on the Curious of the Heathen Lord's robes from the Vault of Glass. So that is also shaded very nicely because it still resembles that like glow around the neck area on the Promethean Knights, which was very genius. There was definitely a lot of thought put into this, and I definitely appreciate it. All right, so next up, we have the one that you probably came here to see, considering that I probably put it in the thumbnail, but we finally have the Master Chief in Destiny 2. Now, I will be completely honest with you. There are tons of ways to make the Master Chief inside of Destiny 2, tons of armor choices. So if you want to show me yours, just go ahead and join my Discord server. There will be a link down below to that. But anyway, back to the Chief. So this one is from Dawson, and I will be leaving his Instagram profile link down below because I think he did an amazing job on these screenshots and the ones that I'm showing you in the background right now that recreate iconic moments in the Halo franchise, but in Destiny 2. And here is the armor that he used to make the Chief. And again, very good job on using different armor pieces for every slot. Not only that, but we're also using Wayfarer's Guise, which is a shader I don't really see used like at all. And then we're also using Basalt Toxic on the head. That way we can get that visor color right. And we're trying to keep it as simple as possible when it comes to the armor here, with the exception of the Krystacrene helmet. That is just basically the closest that we're ever going to get in Destiny when it comes to making Spartan armor. For the rest of the armor, like the Hardcase Brawlers, the key here is to keep it simple and keep it clean. It just really makes me wish that there could have been a way for Bungie to ask 343 and Microsoft for a way for them to like borrow some of the armor sets like the Spartan armor, like Chief's armor, for the 30th anniversary event. But I don't really want to linger on that for too long. Great job, Dawson. I really like your Master Chief cosplay here. And now let's move on to the next one. By the way, if you've been enjoying this video and want to see more content like this, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Come on, you know you want to. But next up, we have one that I was pleasantly surprised to see. We have a Dr. Elizabeth Halsey. And the reason I was surprised on this one is whenever I started the contest, I thought that everyone was going to do like Spartan armor and then call it a day. But then I saw Cerebear submit this one and I was like, wow, people are actually going to be pretty creative in this contest. And just like the other Promethean Knight Warlock, I feel like there was so much thought put into this Warlock. Because if you see the trimming on Dr. Halsey's jacket, which is blue, you also see the same trimming on the Warlock's jacket. On top of that, Halsey has like this yellow name tag thing on her jacket, which then translated over to the yellow warlock bond, and that just blew my mind. Like, the attention to detail is amazing on this warlock. And another added level to this is Halsey, somewhere in Halo 5, I think, because I didn't really play it, she loses her arm, and as you can see here, she has like that part like tied up with her jacket. So it's actually very fitting that they're using wraps for the bond right here. I also feel like the helmet is a very good choice. It looks very elegant, and I think, I can't really tell because I can't really zoom in too much in this picture, but I think there's like a little silver strip coming down at the top of the helmet, which is a nice little homage to the fact that, well, Halsey's old as f- and she has silver hair. And lastly, as the nice little cherry on top, every single piece of armor is from a different set, and there is a lot of different shaders being used here, and everything is just absolutely perfect. Wonderful job, Cerebear. Now at this point you might be wondering, Muffin, where are all the hunters at? Well, here is your first one, and it is based off of the Sangheili honor guard. Now I really think that NotHarv did a great job here, because you can start to really see which individual pieces on the honor guard inspire the armor pieces on the hunter. Like, for example, the light orange protruding areas on the honor guard obviously inspired the like spiky bits on the hunter's armor. And not only that, but like the same general colors from the honor guard are also shared with the hunter. Now this is where I will point out that the colors don't match exactly, but they're still in the same ballpark and you can still get the point. And of course the Sangheili warriors, I hope I'm saying that right, but the Sangheili are kind of based off of samurai, or their way of life is based off of the samurai, which is also why they have energy swords. So I also feel like the samurai iron banner armor being used on the hunter is also very fitting. And again, I do have to give another nod to the fact that they are using a different armor piece in every slot, and there's a good variety of shaders being used here, which always impresses me. Oh, and by the way, since I keep bringing that up, I do always have to give the disclaimer of, it's not how many shaders and armor pieces you use, it's how you use them. Just because you have a bunch of different shaders does not make you better than someone that only uses one shader. It's how you use it and how amazing you look doing it. But regardless of that, thank you very much, NotHarv. You did a wonderful job. And now we're going to be moving on to our last hunter and our last guardian of the day. So this next one is going to be based off of, hey, it's Mango Spartan armor in the game right now. And he decided to replicate this using his hunter, and I think he did a great job. And when you look at them side by side, you can start to really tell where the inspiration came from. Like the giant visor on the contender's mask really matches up with the visor on the Spartan armor. You get the Exodus down grips, which have like these giant shoulder pads and giant things like around the wrist area, which of course matches up with all of the gear that the Spartan has in those same areas. And at first I really thought that they should maybe replace the legs on the hunter, because I didn't think that they fit very well at first. But then I started to actually compare the two side by side, and you can see what he was going for, like the big belt around the Spartan armor. Of course you have that on the Stompies ornament, and then you have like all of the armor on the sides of the legs with the black inner part of the pants. So you can really start to see where that inspiration came from there. At first glance, it's really hard to see, but whenever you start to really analyze every single piece of armor, you can see where everything came from for sure. And you know what? I was expecting a bunch of Titans to like really rule all of these submissions, and I thought it was going to be a landslide win for the Titans. But I really welcome the fact that you managed to make your Spartan armor with hunter armor. So yeah, big pat on the back to you for that. And of course, here is the armor in case you wanted to replicate this. Again, we're seeing a bunch of different armor pieces being used in every single slot, and a very, very good variety of shaders here. And yeah, I was pretty surprised too whenever I gave this its first look, because I thought it was all one shader, but then I looked at the gear and that's what I saw. So yeah, I was super impressed by everybody's submission. Every single one of the six that was shown here today definitely deserves to be up here, but I can only give the seal of approval to one guardian, and I think I'm going to give it to Cerebear. Just because I can tell that there was such attention to detail put into this whole entire armor set, that's why I picked Cerebear. But hey, she won't be the only winner for today because I will also reveal the results of the actual voting that went on in my Discord. So in third place, we have Not Harv's Honor Guard Hunter. In second place, we have Dawson's Master Chief. And the winner of our Halo themed fashion contest goes to Genesis and his Hunter Titan, which feels weird to say. Thank you to everybody that participated. And if you ever want to participate in our weekly weekend fashion contest, remember that my Discord server link will be down below. And you know what else is down below? Your mom. Just kidding. The like button and the subscribe button are also down there, so don't forget to hit those on your way out. I want to give a big thank you to all of our Patreon members. You guys are absolutely amazing. Thank you for supporting me. And Guardians, I will be seeing you guys in the next video. Don't forget to click on any of the videos popping up in the end card now. And as always, stay beautiful.